Hi, and welcome to Dave's Think Tank. A couple of weeks ago, I did a video on the Arduino upgrade that I performed on the Flash Gordon. By adding an Arduino game board to your Pinball's MPU, you can completely reprogram the machine, setting different game rules, different goals, different rewards and penalties. The original software was written a few years back, and the main changes they made to the game were to add a skill shot at the start of each ball and a big boss finale. They also added some really fun swirling light patterns and some added functionality to the game's self-test feature. My big contribution was to add back all the functionality of the original machine. The game settings available through the dip switches for modifying the game difficulty, and the game settings available through the self-test feature. Without all these settings set to the way I like them, it felt like I was playing someone else's game. Now it feels like I'm playing my game. I also made my own additions to the self-test features. In particular, I extended the sound test to allow you to scan through the sounds, find the ones you want, and play them. I also wrote a manual, which would have been really nice to have had when I started this whole project. Since then, I've continued to work on the software and have accumulated enough changes that I felt I needed to put out a new release. First, a couple of fun changes. The attract mode display used to look just like this machine, alternating between the high score and the most recent scores. Now it looks like this. The scores scroll out, flash, and scroll back again. This is a really good demonstration of the level of control you now have over this machine to make it do whatever you can think of. And another change just for fun. Whenever you win some points, the game adds them to the display above. You win 10,000 points, gets added to the display. You win 50,000 points, boom, it's added to the display. And now, if you win 10,000 points,
very roughly 14 seconds,
the display counts up to your new score by thousands. Suppose you win 50,000 points. Again, it counts up to your new total. This just makes the score display a bit more interesting with something going on all the time, even if you haven't hit anything for a while. I've made some additions to the self-test features again. First off, let's look at audit feature 13. Audit feature 13 can be used to review the stats on how many skill shots you've made. Low, middle, and high numbers. You can move between them. Oops, there you go. You can move between them. You can increase them, or you can set them to zero. You can scroll up. Audit feature 14. This is the number of final battles you've entered, and 15 is how many times you've gone on to defeat Ming. The final battle drop target gold was set to 16, so let's go up to 21 here. Frankly, no one could ever make it that high. So I added a self-test game setting. I've got it set to 11 now, which seems like a good number. 11 is the number of drop targets on the playfield. And in the movie, Flash fought Ming's guards as if they were 11 players on a football team. And every once in a while, I actually do get up to 11. Now, since I added the drop target goal to the self-test settings, I also added the final battle attack goal. It was set at 140. And I've left it there, as it's a challenge, but definitely achievable. I did change the spinner contribution, though, from 1 times number of spins to 4 times. 1 point out of 140 just didn't give anyone any incentive to aim for the spinners. The other change I made to the rules was, to enter the final battle, you can now knock down the single target and enter the shooter lane.
The attack has begun.
You can still go down the lit outer lanes to the outhole, but this always felt like something that just happened to you and with little you could do to make it happen. Returning to the shooter lane is a real skill shot and feels like you have more control. I have a Geeteoh soundboard and I wanted to make full use of it. So I've gone through all the sounds and the actions that trigger them, setting them to appropriate quotes from the movie. You just heard Dr. Zarkov saying the battle has begun at the beginning of the final battle. I've also modified the program to avoid voices talking over each other without just dropping the second voice. And all of my sound files are included with my software at the link below. One more thing I've done is to turn on the strobe light. This was all programmed by the original programmer, but he recommended it be turned off. I suspect this is because the original strobe lights used a camera flash, which needed to charge up before discharging. So the number of flashes he programmed would have burnt out your strobe light in no time. But my strobe is just 4 LED lights and is easily up to the challenge. I showed you how you can build one of these out of spare parts around the house in another video. The result is a new, really fun feature that can finally achieve its full potential. I'll leave a link to the new software in the description below. For now, let's play a game.
Gordon, sir.
15,000. Music is turned off for copyright reasons, by the way. Okay, let's try that skill shot. Come on. Oh, 30,000. Okay, we got 3 times. Got the wood beast. Got the same parachutes again because of the wood beast though. So we're still in this game. 15,000. When you get the hurry up over here, Flash tells you to hit those switches over there. And if you hit them, it says Flash. If you don't, it says, oh dear.
Either way, it'll probably bounce right down. Skill shot. A little more. $30,000. Okay, as you know, I'm trying to get 11 drop targets down. See if I get my 11, I'll get it to the final paddle. Okay, got our 11 targets. Yes! Going to meet Ming in the final battle. All I had to do was fall in the saucer. Too much. No! Last ball. 30,000. Come on, you got double points. Hit something. $1.8 million. That is a decent game.